The last couple of months, I've been posting a lot more videos on my social media of work that I've done for small businesses and covering events that I have been to. And since then, my friends and the other lovely people of Instagram have been asking me how I do some of the techniques that were in these videos. If you're new to this channel, my name is Camilo and this is DKD21 Media, the place where I teach you how to step up your video production in the simplest and quickest way possible. So what was the editing technique that they mostly asked about? Speed ramping. Speed ramping is when you take a clip and change its speed from fast to slow in a smooth curve as opposed to a sharp change in speed. This is great when you're shooting at high frame rates, 60 FPS and above, and you are working on a 24 or 30 frames per second timeline for which you can slow the footage down. So if you have a 24 frames per second timeline and a 60 frames per second clip, you can slow it down by 40%. Speed ramping is a great way to tell a story by emphasizing an action, movement, or even to transition to and from a clip. As a basic principle, speed ramping looks like this. Now, by the way, this is done in Premiere Pro CC. So if you don't have Premiere Pro and you're using something like Final Cut, the principle stays the same. So you want to find the clip that you want to work with. In this case, I'm shooting a video for my friend's website, who is a photographer in the busy city of London. I shot at 60 frames per second and I slowed it down by 40%. So if you hover your mouse over here and you hold the Alt key or option and you scroll up, you actually increase the thickness of your clip. And then what you want to do is you want to go right click, time remapping, speed, and then you have a bar here that you can see. If you were to scroll it up or down, you can see different percentages, and that is the percentage of speed that your clip is going to move at. And then what you want to do is you want to find on the clip where you want to slow the clip down. If you press P or the pen tool, you get a little pen. So I found a spot here. Press V on my keyboard or go to the selection tool. I can increase the slider on the left side of the point upwards. I'll increase it by 500%. So you can see in this clip, the slow motion emphasizes the rotational motion of the camera. But let's move this out so that it's not too sharp. If you grab one of these pins here, you can get a sideways arrow. Simply drag this outward slightly to slow down the time between the fast clip and the slow clip. You can drag it out as far as you want. You increase the thickness of the clip some more. Now, if you click one of the markers and you zoom in to the middle, you get to see a blue dot with some handles. So if you hover your mouse over one of the handles and then you click and you drag it until you make an S shape, you'll smoothen out the transition between the fast clip and the slow clip, allowing the shot to change in speed in a much smoother way. So just a quick tip, it always looks better when you go from fast to very slow. If you go from very fast to normal speed, it doesn't look as good because the difference is greater and it makes it more dramatic. So try incorporating this more than once. As you can see in this video, I had people walking past and I had it in slow motion, then I sped it up and again, very slow. It just adds a bit more of a dramatic story to it. If there is more than one point that you want to emphasize on or slow down on, definitely try this. You can see in this clip here that I wanted the clip to speed up and slow back down when Kevin changes his camera from one portrait side to the other portrait side. I just thought that this action was quite dramatic and it shows him off as a photographer. So I just did the same thing, used the pen tool, found the points I wanted to go to, slowed it down, created a ramp, and then I created an S curve. However, as you can see here, I want it to be a little bit faster, but 1000% isn't enough. So this is probably a good time for a quick tip. So you may notice that when you increase the speed of your shot, you have a max of 1000%, which is a lot, but maybe if your shot is a slower frame rate or there's a lot between one shot and the other, it's not enough. So if you come across this situation, the best way to overcome this is to grab your razor tool and right after the curve and right before the next curve is when you want to slice it. Don't slice on the curve, everything will just fuck. You want to right click on that section, speed, duration, and then increase the speed. Now the speed of it has increased and I'm quite happy with the way it turned out. When shooting, leave some space before and after the clip where you swipe the camera left or right and follow through with the same direction. 100% make it an easy way to transition from one clip to the next, especially if you're doing a lot of speed ramps. So here we have two more clips. You can see in one of the clips, I swiped out of the clip, and in the other clip, I swiped into the clip. So right off the bat, you can see, even if I just put them next to each other, they blend in really well because they follow the same motion. However, let's increase the speed towards the end of it so it happens a bit much quicker. At the end of the clip, I put my marker, increase the speed, make an S curve, and then in the next clip, I do exactly the same thing and make sure that when I play it back, you can see some of the motion blur. And as you can see, I go from one shot to the next shot very seamlessly and decreases to a slow motion. Sound design is basically the use of external sounds to emphasize actions in your shot. It's one of those things that, and the audience would not notice us there, they just kind of go with it. So I'll show you what I mean. So I've been curating a lot of sounds to use for video editing. One of the sounds that I use is the swoosh. So in this clip, we have two speed ramps. What you want to do is when you drag it into your Premiere Pro, just cut out the unnecessary white space. And then what you want to do is you want to drag it into every speed ramp you do. Make sure it's in line with the actual footage and it sounds like you're doing a swoosh from fast to slow. If you want to get this sound, the link is in the description. It'll take you to my website where you will find it. If you're not using sound design, you definitely want to speed ramp to the music. I would listen up for some open hats, such as the kss, kss. Why? Because open hats and cymbals are designed to make you step back when you're dancing to a track. It's one of those things in percussion that you don't really know about, but yeah, open hats make you want to step back and forward. In this case, we found a riser. And the riser is where I want to transition from one clip to the next. So what I do is I get the riser and then I sync it up to where the transition occurs. And when you play it, it goes with it and it's not just a random transition that occurs. And when you've done that, your final product should look something like this. So I hope you enjoyed that video, guys, and you learned something new. Leave a like if you liked it, and let me know in the comments if you want to see more tutorials like these. Let me know other things that you've seen from my videos that you want me to teach you. I have another YouTube channel where I upload pretty much all of my videos. Hit subscribe, and we'll come at you with some more videos soon.